The following program is a paid commercial program. Views expressed belong to its participants and are not necessarily those of the management and staff of News Channel 11.
Hello, come on in. Let's cook together. Well, the recipes are rolling in now, and I'm so tickled. I have a new recipe that Debbie McNew from Bluntville sent me, and so that's what we're preparing today with our Food for Thought. This is one of the most simplest recipes that you'll probably ever prepare in your life. What we're going to start with is some very, very ripe bananas. And as you can see, these are sort of dark looking, but that's what you want. So what we're going to do is we're going to peel them, and we are going to mash them with my little handy dandy masher instead of a mixer. But now you could use a mixer if you wanted to use a mixer. But I just thought we'd just do it real old school with this. With this recipe, what's wonderful about it is there is no sugar. So if you're a diabetic, this would be great. There is no eggs. There is no flour. What else could you ask for? All right, now I've got all my bananas. Now it takes 3 cups of bananas. So I'm gonna mash them up with my little handy dandy masher. And while I'm doing this, you all just keep sending me those recipes and visit us on Facebook, or you know, come by the deli here and give me those. And on this recipe, once we get it all finished, it's gonna go into a 8x4 pan, loaf pan, or you can use small pans if you'd like. Okay, now I have my bananas mashed up. It's gonna take 1/3 cup of applesauce. And I used unsweetened. Okay, now it's gonna take 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Oh, you can dump all this in at one time. 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. And then it calls for raisins, I guess because this is a healthy banana bread. But I'm gonna use some walnuts in mine. So I'm gonna dump all that in there. We're gonna stir it up real quick. Sort of get that cinnamon going so it doesn't lump. Now, it also calls for 2 cups of oats, or oatmeal, whichever you want to call it. I'll call it oatmeal. All right, this is all gonna be stirred up, and it's gonna go into an oven of 350 degrees, and it'll only stay 15 to 20 minutes. And if you know your oven, then you know it might not have to stay that long. This is a real moist bread. And if you've got a sweet tooth and you just really don't want to break out that candy bar, this would suit you very well with that. Folks, I want you to come see me here at the deli. And I also want you to visit me on Facebook. I think I mentioned that just a minute ago. Now, I want Debbie to know this is wonderful. So this is what it looks like. And I'm going to put it in my loaf pan. Also, this is wonderful for a brunch or lunch after it's baked. You could take and put it with some chicken salad and some fresh fruit. So what I thought I would do is show you how to fan a strawberry. And I guess you can see me there where I'm moving this stuff out of the way. I'm gonna take and fan it like this. And then we're gonna do it like that. This is sort of what you would see for a garnish. And I'm going to place it just about right there. Now, we have our bread here. I have sliced it. My idea of something really great would be with the chicken salad. And we have chicken salad here at the deli. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pinch me off a piece of this bread. And I'm going to take me just a little bit of bite of this. Does that not look yummy? Mm-mm-mm. Boy, oh boy. That just makes you want to run around the building here. But I hope that you will come see me. It won't be long. That train's going to be blowing its whistle, and I've got my mouth full. But also, I garnish this with a little bit of oranges. You could flavor it with orange juice if you'd like. Some fresh raspberries, some strawberries. I think that this is a wonderful recipe for those folks that are gluten tolerant, that they need gluten-free products. So come see me. Well, that train's leaving. I've got to go. Bye.